station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Catherine McLaurin. This summer, we're hitting the road to show off some of the sights at the Johnson Space Center. Today, we're in the Space Vehicle Mock-up Facility, where every station astronaut trains in life-size simulators before their stay in space. This week in space, though, kicked off with an early morning release of Dragon. SpaceX's cargo ship was packed with over 4,100 pounds of science experiments and equipment by the Expedition 52 crew to prepare for its departure. The hatch was closed, and Dragon was detached from station over the weekend, with the crew releasing it from the station's robotic arm on Monday. Dragon flew away from the station and eventually re-entered through the Earth's atmosphere, splashing down in the Pacific Ocean for the end of another successful mission. And being off the planet didn't stop the NASA crew from celebrating Independence Day. Peggy Whitson and Jack Fisher got dressed up for the 4th of July, donning their most patriotic gear for a quick photo session. As a reminder, you can follow both of them during their stay aboard the space station on Twitter at AstroPeggy and Astro2Fish. This week's Twitter question comes from Matt Reed, who wanted to know if fireworks could work in space. They could, but will look very different than what you see here on Earth. Combustion experiments on the station show that flames form very differently in microgravity environment, creating balls of fire free from the convection process of hot air rising that we have here on Earth. Outside a spacecraft, though, in the vacuum of space, exploding fireworks would be far less spectacular than what you see on Earth, where no atmosphere means very few colors beyond the initial burst and no sound. Lucky for the astronauts, the Earth can provide some pretty spectacular fireworks of its own. Keep sending your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.